Just wanted to give you a little update. This next update, I was hoping to talk about all the supplements I am either currently taking or have on order, but I wanted to talk about a few things before I got to that point. The day before yesterday, we backed off on my oregano oil and grapefruit seed extract because I was having some really strong herxes, and we figured it would be a good idea to let me detox a lot since that's so very important. And so today, though, we're back taking those meds again, and so it's, those 2 days weren't exactly great, but they were a little relief, and now I'm back to a lot of pain, nausea, poor memory and concentration. It's frustrating. So I know in my last video I was upset that the nurse at my neurologist office was really blowing off our inquiry to do some more Lyme testing, since I did have some positive results, and you know, if they weren't positive enough for them, let's investigate more, because hey, I'm showing all the symptoms. Every single one of my symptoms can be explained by Lyme. None of them, I don't have any symptoms that fall outside of that. No other tests show positive, and they would rather laugh in my husband's face when he wants to do more testing instead of proposing any other solutions. You know, they want to work on a real diagnosis, but they're not doing any more testing right now. They don't seem to really be concerned that over the past 3 months since they've started seeing me, my progression, my disability has become so pronounced. And instead of acknowledging all my physical symptoms, instead of trying to get me in the office ASAP like they originally were talking about doing before my Western blot came back not positive enough, they pushed me off till the second week of January, and before they see me, they want permission to talk to my psychiatrist. So they're pretty much going in the way that they don't know what it is, and since none of their tests are showing positive for anything, it must be all in my head. Doesn't matter that I have sat down with the doctor and had very intellectual conversations about possible outcomes, diseases such as that. It doesn't seem to matter. Once people have something in their heads, it seems to be hard to change their mind despite overwhelming amounts of evidence. And along those lines, I've been a bit frustrated the past couple of days. Well, frustrated is not really the word. Extremely disappointed and upset because some members of my family, and I'll just leave it at that, who were initially seeming very proactive about my Lyme, have for some reason started to think that, well, maybe it's not. Maybe, you know, me and my husband are just chasing these rabbit holes that we've been on these last few years, because we've known something was wrong, and so we've been researching things, but we've never, like, you know, pushed the issue with doctors, never done this or that, and finally we actually have something real. I'm crippled. I am in a wheelchair, and they can't be bothered to take off to come see me. And they said if they would if I was inpatient in the hospital, and said they didn't want to come up here I don't know how to phrase it correctly because I don't know the exact words, but they basically said that, you know, they come up here if I was inpatient in the hospital, but other than that, since everything was so wishy-washy with what was going on, they didn't want to waste a trip. You know, they say blood runs thicker than water. Maybe from a scientific perspective. But I'm rambling. So I went to my primary care physician today because I'm getting bad and bad, and we've been treating it ourselves, which is helping. Thank goodness we've been able to do some research and do some natural treatment, because I can't imagine where I'd be without. But, so my primary care physician, who has seen us over 3 years, they pretty much were really hands-off when I was going to my specialist neurologist, because of course they're specialists, they're supposed to figure out these weird stuff you're having, right? Well, you know, they've been real slow with us, and we've had a lot of patients, and my primary care physicians have had a lot of patients. And when I came in today in my wheelchair, and my resting pulse just sitting there was 112, they began to get a lot more frustrated that my neurologist wasn't taking things seriously enough or at all. I'm not really sure. I liked him to be in my body for just a day, and we'll see how seriously he takes it. But, so, she said that, you know, she knows the tests haven't come back positive, but she's sick and tired of waiting around for them to do something, and so she went ahead and prescribed me a month of doxycycline, because she said that, you know, it's not going to hurt anything, and maybe it'll help, and she's sick of waiting, watching me get worse, while everybody else is kind of twiddling their thumbs, or like, gee, we don't know what's wrong with you. Sucks. Maybe it's all in your head. Yeah, because I want to be on medical leave from a job that I like, that pays me well. I like my coworkers, I like being up here. I like going outside and running around in creeks in the mountains, but, oh, I'd rather be sick in bed to have somebody take care of me. Bullshit. This is why I'm making this vlog. Because when I first started seeing how some people weren't taking very seriously, I was afraid that would happen to me. And some of my family members who aren't really taking me seriously don't seem to understand that if this is left untreated, it will kill me. It kills lots of people. But guess what? Their cause of death is put down as heart disease, or ALS. They have their priorities, apparently. You know what? I have mine. And my life can't be stressed by things like that. It's too precious. And it's time to move on. But before I ended this, I wanted to mention just some things today, because I mentioned dysautonomia problems, and from what I've been reading lately, it seems like a lot of people with late Lyme have dysautonomia problems. And so I've mentioned that I, you know, have problems with the high heart rate, and I can't withstand hotter temperatures, and, you know, saunas and, you know, hot bath will really just mess me up. And so we took my blood pressure when I woke up this morning, and not when we woke up, but at the doctor's office. The doctor's office found my resting heart rate to be 112 at a blood pressure of 121 over 79. That's about what it's been here recently. And then I was going to try to take a bath, which pretty much I just run just enough water that if I want to kind of lay down, it'll almost cover the tops of my legs. I can't put much. But after about 5 minutes of being in there, which is usual, my heart starts beating so fast, and I get out of breath, and, you know, my husband has to help me out. And so, right when it was, you know, we were getting me out, we're like, well, let's check my blood pressure and heart rate. So we got the monitor out, and my blood pressure was 103 over 54, with a heart rate of 141. And, you know, and after about 10 minutes, of me laying on the bed in the cool bedroom, you know, trying to breathe and get some air, my heart rate calmed down and stuff, and then we measured again at blood pressure 117 over 66 with a heart rate of 90. And so, yeah, it really sucks because I used to love these really nice long hot baths and showers. And now if we lay in the, if I'm just laying in the bedroom, which I do all the time, all day long, another frustrating thing. But even if the bedroom gets too hot, just from ambient temperature of the heater, it makes my heart start going fast and everything. But I did get a reference to a cardiologist from my primary care physician because I really need to know what's going on with my heart. I know some of the problems are from dysautonomia issues, but I know Lyme can affect your heart as well, and I want to know about that because since we're currently pretty much being left to fend for ourselves with treating this, which is really fucked up. I want to know how my heart is because we need to know this for Herc's reactions, because when I am having bad ones, I'll get the heart palpitations and heart skips a lot more frequently, and we need to know how much we need to be aware of that. So I'm writing down all my supplements and everything and making a list of all of the things I'm either taking or going to be taking soon when they're in the mail. So hopefully that'll be the next post. What a wonderful journey. I'm alive and I have a greater deal of appreciation for a lot of things that really only come with experience like this. And so, I just want to say hi to every one of my friends and coworkers out there, and I'm stubborn and I'm fighting this, and I'm going to do this. I'm going to beat this.